Hello everyone, welcome to the video lectures of Nano Electronics. Today we are going to start the sixth module. In this module we will discuss about nano electronic devices. Okay, today's session I will discuss about the structure and working of MOSFET or high speed electron mobility transistor. Modulation doped field effect transistor or MOSFET is a field effect transistor having a conducting channel at the junction of two dissimilar band gap materials. A two-dimensional electron gas or 2DEG layer acts as a channel with very high mobility for the electrons. So the device is also commonly known as high electron mobility transistor or HEMT. H-E-M-T. And the most important feature of MOSFET is the increased mobility of electrons in the heterojunction layer and its improved performance. Now we can look into the device structure. So here a cross-sectional view of a typical MOSFET is shown. The structure is similar to classical MOSFET, except the feature of conducting channel layer. It consists of source, drain and gate electrodes. These conducts are made up of metal layers commonly, or it can be fabricated using heavily doped gallium arsenide layers. And the layers of MOSFET are metals, then n-type L-gas, then intrinsic gas. Here it is denoted as I gas, which means intrinsic gallium arsenide, and the basement layer. The basement layer can be insulating layer, insulating substrate. And at the junction of L gas gas, there is intrinsic L gas or the spacer, commonly known as spacer layer, which is represented as a red colored layer here. Okay. The most important characteristics of MOSFET are the two-dimensional electron gas that offers the flow of electrons with very high mobility, which is represented as a green colored layer. The quantum well is formed at the interface due to the larger band gap of L gas as compared to that of gallium arsenide. In the previous modules also we have discussed about that. As we have discussed in fifth module, a triangular quantum well is formed at the interface. There is two-dimensional electron gas, and the need for intrinsic L gas here, or the spacer layer, that will be discussed in later stage. Here, we can see the triangular quantum well formed at the junction at the interface. As we have seen in the previous modules, the band bending will be based on the direction of electric field, and since we are using different band gap materials here, see at the interface there will be shift in conduction band, that is delta EC downwards. So a notch and a well is formed at the interface. The width of two-dimensional electron gas is about 8 to 10 nanometer, and these trapped electrons in the well have better conductivity because the effective mass of electron in gallium arsenide is on the lower side, and hence the mobility will be very very high. In the well, we can see the subbands. The trapped electrons in the well will first occupy these low energy levels, and these subbands will be completely filled, and after that the higher energy levels will be filled. In fact, the speed of the transistor depends on the electrons in the lower energy bands, because we know as the energy levels increases, the mobility of electrons decreases due to the scattering effect. So the electrons in the lower energy level really matters. See, the electrons are transferred from L gas to gas due to the difference in electron affinity. So these electrons take part in the conduction process through the two-dimensional electron gas channel. Here also you can clearly see the difference in conduction energy levels, delta EC. Okay. Again, look at the structure of MOSFET. Now we can discuss about the need for intrinsic gas layer or the spacer layer at the junction, at the interface. In heterostructure, two-dimensional electron gas is formed in gallium arsenide. However, electron may have some impurity scattering in the n-type algias, and this is avoided by providing an undoped algias layer as a spacer layer. So it isolates the conducting electron channel from the n-type algias layer, which generates the carriers. The width of the intrinsic algias is about 5 to 6 nanometer. And here, when a voltage is applied between source and drain, a conduction will take place through the two-dimensional electron gas with a very high mobility. And we know that electrons will prefer a high-speed channel between source and drain. So here, it is through the two-dimensional electron gas formed at the interface of algias gas. This channel current or the drain current can be altered or modulated by a voltage signal given to the gate terminal. So here also the gate terminal is the controlling terminal. Even though it have a high switching speed in MOSFETs, its IV characteristics are similar to those of classical MOSFETs. Now we can discuss about the advantages of MOSFETs. So basically it can operate over a wide range of frequencies, high frequencies, and then low noise level, and the cutoff frequency is much higher than classical silicon based MOSFETs, and it will have a high switching speed and a better gain than classical field effect transistors. So next question is where we can use these high speed transistors. So MOSFETs are used in signal amplification in the range from few gigahertz to around 300 gigahertz. And since these transistors can work under very high frequencies, it can be used during the fabrication of microwave ICs. So it's very important in microwave industry, and it is also used in cellular phones, then in radar systems, in communication devices, in space stations, etc. So we can conclude the session. So MOSFETs or HEMT perform better than classical MOSFETs. In the next video session, we can discuss about heterojunction bipolar transistors. Okay, thank you for watching.